everyone, welcome back to Swiss Home Garden. Chitra here. In this video, I will be showing you how to make ghee from raw milk butter. Sometime back, I posted a video on how to make butter from raw milk. We did that by first collecting the cream from raw milk and then convert it into butter. I will leave a link below in the description box for that video too. Please take a look at it in case you haven't watched it. In Ayurveda, ghee is referred to as liquid gold. There are many health benefits when you consume ghee and cook with ghee. Ghee is packed with fat-soluble vitamins that it can boost your intake of vitamin A, E and K. Lactose intolerant people are able to tolerate ghee, and I'm not making a claim on this, but out of personal experience I can say that my daughter, who is lactose intolerant, can easily tolerate ghee. In fact, I give lots of ghee to her. This is probably the only dairy that she can easily digest, and it has had not a negative effect in her body. Why is it that lactose intolerant people can take ghee? Is that because all the milk solids and casein will be separated when you're cooking the butter. So this is the advantage of separating all these milk solids, which is what is causing problem. If you're making ghee like I do from grass-fed butter, this also has an additional benefit of having this conjugated linoleic acid. And this is very essential for your gut and for digestion. It boosts your digestion. Some of the other benefits of ghee is that it has a very high smoking point. Ghee also has a longer shelf life away from the refrigerator. You do not need to refrigerate ghee. So these are the main benefits that I know of, but there are lots of it, and this is what comes to my mind basically now. So let's get started in making ghee. I will be making ghee in two different ways. The first one will be the traditional way which I learned from my mother. I will not be removing the froth which is coming up when you're heating the butter. I will leave it as it is, and this milk solids will settle to the bottom after some time. The texture of this will be different than the other method which I've been seeing lately some people doing, that they remove out the froth. So there is a difference to both of these methods. The first method will give a nutty flavor to the ghee, and in the second method I will remove the foam and the froth, and you can see for yourself the difference between both the ghees. And this butter over here is raw milk butter. I made this yesterday using my KitchenAid mixer, and this butter is also from grass-fed cows, and this is from the health food store. With this, I will be making ghee the traditional way, and the other one by removing the froth. First, let me do this one, and then I will be doing this. So for this, you will also need heavy bottom pan, and then I have a sieve to sieve it with a muslin cloth. And I will be using upcycled glass jars. There's not many things which are needed for this. In a heavy bottom pan, add in all the butter and heat it on low to medium heat. In this pot, there is about 450 to 500 grams of butter, and the whole process of making this ghee wouldn't take more than 15 to 20 minutes. So if you are doing something else in the kitchen and keep an eye on it, it's perfect. Just don't leave it unattended. You see here that the butter has completely melted and that it is starting to boil at this stage. You can burn this butter if you are not watchful, and it is better to keep this at a low heat. This is the first stage, and it is the foaming stage. This is the stage where I have seen people removing out the foam, but I will not be bothering with this because eventually all this will settle down to the bottom of the pot, and this is where the flavor of this ghee differs from the other one. And the second foaming stage is when the big bubbles start to form, and that is when the ghee is done. You see that the butter is slowly clarifying and the frothing stage is passing. The milk solids are also separating, and at this point also, if there are water particles inside the butter, it will start to evaporate. Because this is homemade butter, I had also left the butter in a water bath in the fridge before I started to make the ghee. So you can expect a lot of splash around this time. It starts to sound different now that it is boiling. Depending on your stove, you keep it at a sim level. I've kept it at 4 in my induction flame. You can see that the milk solids are separating and settling below. This one will be filtered out. At this stage, I will be adding a few cloves. This will enhance the flavor. My mother used to also add one big crystal salt to ensure that all the water has evaporated from the butter. We can even add a few moringa leaves to check if all the water is gone. When it starts to splutter, means then it is ready. So right now I will be just adding this to add the flavor to the ghee. This stage is the last stage and the big bubbles are forming. That means the ghee will be soon ready. I will be filtering out all the debris and all the milk solids by using a thin muslin cloth on top of a filter. You could filter out this ghee using a fine sieve, but I prefer to use this muslin cloth because I don't want any of the smaller milk solids floating around in the ghee. And there you see at the bottom of the pot all of the solids which have been separated out. Store the clear ghee in a clean and dry glass jar. I usually store them at room temperature, and if I have made a lot of it, I do keep it in the cellar and they last easily up to 6 months without any problems. Let's begin with the second ghee. Begin by heating a heavy bottom pan on low to medium heat. Add in all the butter and then proceed as before. The only difference is that now when the butter starts to foam, we will be removing the foam out and separating it from the rest. You will have to be separating this foam or these milk solids for about 10 minutes. After this, the ghee will start boiling, and it is as before, you will have to wait till it starts to form big bubbles before you can filter it out. For me personally, this is quite a time consuming job because in the previous case I can just leave it unattended and just keep a watchful eye now and then, but this is a little bit too much work for me. This is what is called clarified butter, and we do get clarified butter here in Switzerland too. This is not the stage at which it is called ghee, so we will be continuing to boil further till it reaches the ghee consistency. That means that all the water has evaporated and then the bigger bubbles start to form. So let's continue doing that till that stage comes. Once it starts to form the big bubbles, as usual I will be adding a couple of cloves for the flavor. And if you want to test if it is completely devoid of any of the water, you can add in a couple of moringa leaves if you have, or a big crystal of salt. And then you know that when the salt remains at the bottom, there is no water in it. Since I have already removed out the milk solids at the beginning, you will not find much of a debris at the bottom of the pot. Now the ghee has formed. You can see the bigger bubbles forming, and at this stage I will be switching it off. As before, I will be filtering this despite removing all the milk solids and transferring it into a clean and dry glass jar and leaving it overnight to show you the difference of the texture the next day. I left both of this ghee overnight, and I will be showing you how the texture looks inside. The bottle with the silver lid is the ghee we made by removing all the milk solids. The second bottle with the golden lid was the ghee which we made first by leaving all the milk solids undisturbed. The texture is grainy and it does smell also really delicious. The ghee in this bottle has a more grainier texture than the other one. The flavor of this ghee is very nutty. As I said, because we left all the milk solids undisturbed, this gives this special flavor. The difference between the texture is not that much. It's just the flavor which differs in both of these ghees. So it is a matter of personal choice how you make your ghee. For me personally, I don't like to be removing out the foam. It takes too much attention. I prefer to keep an eye now and then on the ghee while I'm making the ghee. I hope you enjoyed watching this video, and thank you for watching. I will leave a link to the other video of how I made butter from raw milk in the description box below. If you're new to my channel, kindly subscribe. I post one new video every week on food from scratch, Swiss country living and our gardening experiences. Kindly hit that bell button to receive notifications for the latest videos I've uploaded. Until next time, bye-bye.